One was masculine and one was feminine, and so they fell in love. This is then the masculine one told the feminine one how he felt about their qualities. You are feminine but very masculine, while I am masculine but very feminine, and such a masculine and such a feminine as is his perfect personalities. So please be my masculine, and if you let me, I will be your feminine. We once felt so inadequate, it almost had a bit, but now that's past. And so the feminine went out as masculine, she wore top hat and tails each night. And the masculine went out as feminine, he even wore high heels despite his height. And the feminine supports the masculine at home, the masculine cooks for the feminine. Still the masculine one and the feminine one felt that something wasn't working right. They both felt the other to be far too masculine or far too feminine. And finally they got slightly loudly, so it was reconciled and for no more. What makes a feminine? A real feminine remains, although it's out of sight. And the same applies to every masculine, although it's hard to hide when working right. And when the masculine, aggressive feminine, enwrapped the feminine, submissive masculine, they had a handsome, pretty masculine feminine, a very cute hermaphrodite. Thought of neuter. There's no cuter neuter and masculine.